Hi folks, Jeremy Schaefer here. Today I'm going to show you how to fold my 16 pointed lotus flower picture frame. This is a model that I designed when I was about 15 years old and I never diagrammed it, but now I'm going to show you how to fold it, and I'm also going to show you how to fold this variation. It's a container with a picture frame inside. So for the container I used a 12 inch square of kami, and for the lid I used a square that's 1/4 the size, so this was a 6 inch square. Alright, here we go. Alright, so let's begin colored side up. We're going to start out by folding an 8x8 grid of creases. So let's fold in half. And I'm using a 12 inch square, but you could probably use a 10 inch square or even a 6 inch square. Okay, and unfold, and let's fold to the crease. And rotate 180 degrees, and let's fold this edge to here. Make your creases nice and sharp. Okay, now let's fold this edge to the top. Okay, and let's rotate 180 degrees, and let's fold this edge to here. Okay, now turn over, and let's fold this edge to the crease. And rotate 180 degrees, and let's fold this edge to here. Alright. Now let's unfold, and you can see we divided this into 8. Now let's rotate 90 degrees, and let's divide this into 8. So, let's first turn over, and let's fold in half again, and we're going to repeat the same thing. Okay, and let's completely unfold. Now we're going to divide the diagonal into 8. So let's start out by folding diagonally in half. And let's go ahead and fold the other diagonal. So fold in half like this. Alright, now let's unfold, colored side up, let's fold the corners to the middle. Okay, now let's unfold, and now we're going to fold this corner to right here. And unfold. And now we're going to do the same thing on the other 3 corners. And now let's fold the corner right to this crease, so right to here. And same thing on the other 3 corners. Now let's fold this flap up, and let's do the same thing on the other 3 corners. Alright, now let's turn over, and let's fold this edge to the crease, unfold, and let's do the same thing on the other 3 edges. Now let's fold diagonally in half like this, unfold, and diagonally in half like this. And and unfold. And now we're going to fold a pinwheel base. So let's fold this edge up and fold this edge up. And now squeeze this corner and make it stick up like that. And let's do the same thing on the other three corners. So squeeze the corner and make it stick up. And squeeze like this. And here's your pinwheel base. And now let's squash these four corners. So stick your finger in there and squash, 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 and squash. All right, now we are going to petal fold these four corners. Okay, so we're going to petal fold, but we're not going to do any pre-creases. We're just going to fold it up like this, and we're going to fold this edge to here, and fold this edge to the crease. Just like that. And on this side, we're going to do the same thing. So fold this edge to here, and this edge to here. And now we're going to repeat on the other three corners. Okay. Now what we're going to do is hold right here on this edge and just pull it to the right. And that will release these layers like that and flatten them. Okay. Now let's do the same thing on the right side. So hold right here and we're going to pull to the left, releasing the layers and flatten down like this. And this flap will just stick up like that. Okay, let's rotate 90 degrees and let's do it right here. So let's hold right here and pull, and here and pull, and make the flap stick up. And let's do the other two areas like that. Okay, so we have these four flaps sticking up. Let's take these two flaps and fold them down, and let's fold these two flaps up. Now, let's fold this edge down like this, and fold this edge down like this. Okay, and put your finger in here and squash. And now let's petal fold. Okay, let's rotate 180 degrees and we're going to do the same thing. So let's fold these two flaps down and squash here. And petal fold. Now let's rotate 90 degrees and let's fold these two flaps down and fold these two flaps up, and let's do the same thing. So let's fold these down like this and squash and petal fold. And rotate 180 degrees, and same thing. Okay, so we still have these white flaps sticking up. Now comes the rather tricky step. It's not too bad though. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to pull this up and fold this up. Now we're going to press on this point like this, and we're going to fold this mountain fold so it's just like this. Fold there, and we're going to fold this mountain fold. So we have this right triangle, right like that. I'm going to show you what it looks like from this side. Okay? Now we're going to flatten this triangle right down to the ground. So what you're gonna do is flatten this edge to right here. Now we fold it to right there, and these two edges come together like that, and this flattens down like that. And the same thing on the right side. So push this in and fold this edge to right here. These two edges squeeze together, and we fold up like this, and we have our big white right triangle. Now we're going to do the same thing on the other flaps. Okay, so open here and open here, and push here and push here. So we have our right triangle, and now we're going to flatten the triangle down. So we push here and flatten, and push here and flatten. Like that. Okay, let's do it again. Okay, and rotate, and one more time. All right. Now let's reach in and pull the raw corners out. Okay, and let's make a square base. So let's fold these two corners down to here. And flatten. And let's do the same thing on the other three corners. Okay, and now let's petal fold these four corners. Alright, so there we have a nice 8-pointed star, and the last step is we just fold up these corners as far as they go. Just fold up the flaps. Okay, now you could actually stick a picture right into here if you don't want these extra flaps. That would work, but then you'd have to cut it perfectly. I'd recommend just folding these flaps up. That way you have four more flaps to your flower. Okay, now the question is, how do you stick the picture in here? Well, what you want to do is, well, fold all of the corners so that they point to the middle again. And now it should be easier to open up. You open up right here and here, basically as if you're going to unfold it. Okay. And now it's sufficiently opened, and you can just stick the picture into the pocket. And hopefully the creases will have enough memory that you can refold them. And there it is. So that's the picture frame. Uh-oh, now I need to take the picture out again, because I want to show you how to make the container. So, to make the container, what you do is just pinch on this edge and this edge. Just pinch them together, and it helps to use this hand inside here just to provide support. And just push them together like that. And same thing, push these two edges together. And push these two edges. And these two. Okay, so here we have a container, but you might want to make it look a little bit nicer by defining the edges. Or you might not. I mean, it's kind of nice to have a round container, but okay, if you want to, just pinch from here to here, and it helps once again to have your hand inside to provide support. And pinch from here to here. And just go around the square. Okay, now if you want to define these creases, then what you can do is we're going to valley fold this corner right to this intersection of creases. And that will make this crease. And it helps if you fold from inside to actually really crease it. Okay, there's our crease there, and let's do it on this side. So let's fold this corner to this intersection point. All right, so there's our creases like that, and let's repeat three more times. All right, so there it is. And now you just want to fold these flaps out again so that it stays. Just go along the edge of the box. All right, and there it is. And now for the lid, once again, you want to use a paper that's a quarter of the size. So this was a 12-inch square, and this was a 6-inch square. And we just put it right on like that. And it shouldn't fall through because the flaps are there, like that. And it creates a more detailed lotus flower. All right, so there is the lotus container, and put something special inside. All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed folding your lotus, and let me know what you think. See you guys later. Bye bye.